Good morning, everybody. This is Brittany and Seth at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. Thank you guys for joining us this morning. We're waiting on Master Keeper Marie, who will be showing up shortly with meds and supplements. So we're gonna tag along with her this morning. This is Seth, and he's our first stop, so I figured we'd just come on over and say hi to him. Hi, Bev. Hello, Elizabeth. What are you doing, big guy? He's gonna get my steps in for me today. He knows he's the first stop on the treat and breakfast train. Good morning, Tanya. Hello, Michelle. Hi, Noor. Hi, Tony. Thank you guys so much for joining us this morning. Hi, Laurel.
Hey, what are you doing? Just stop and hang out for a second. There we go. Stay right here.
Oh, that's a close-up. Good morning, Margot.
You gonna get sneaky on me? Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. So we're going to be following Master Keeper Marie as she does morning meds and supplements today. So we're going to see a good variety of cats. We'll see bobcats, we'll see lynx, we'll see servals, some more tigers. We will attempt Cameron. This is Seth showing off for the volunteers that are just now arriving at 7:30.
What are you doing?
Thank you, Polly.
Keep moving out of my screen.
Rescue in Tampa, Florida.
Good morning, Lauren.
So Seth is our official greeter, and at 7:30 is when most of our volunteers arrive. So he's always the first one everyone sees. Oh, thank you, Karen, for your donation. Okay, so that's his wind up. Back around the corner here. And everybody knows that look. We have grown catnip in the past. I'm not sure if they currently have any. I know we're growing mint. Breezy, one of our bobcats, absolutely loves fresh mint. Good morning, Donna. So it looks like the treat cart has arrived. This is Seth Tiger. And he lives at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. Well, I thought he was gonna come join me down here. He has to make sure that he greets every person that arrives on property. So Marie is over here now. Marie is a master keeper. There he goes. Now he's running for his treat. Yeah, everything's fine with Carol. Yep, Carol brought me on board for a variety of reasons, but to also bring you live feeds earlier in the morning. She typically will still be doing evening ones, some throughout the day, but this frees Carol up to do more important things for the cats, stuff I certainly can't do.
Hi. Sleepy boy. Meow, meow. Boy, here.
Thank you, Joanna.
Sleepy boy. Yum, yum.
Good job, buddy.
All right, breakfast comes next.
Yeah. All right, guys, so we're gonna hop on the cart with Marie.
Hello.
So Marie is gonna take us around and we're gonna do meds and supplements for a variety of cats today.
Hi,
Seth's actually about 14. Good morning, Pam.
He does love his treats.
He'll get his full breakfast. What you guys are seeing right now is just little treats that have their meds and supplements in it. They will get their full diets, which he gets about 10 pounds a day. They'll get those next. I'm not sure if we'll follow for those today or not. I have to see what else is on the agenda. Always a busy day here at the sanctuary. Yep, that's candy in front of us.
Hi, Candy.
Good morning.
Candy.
Good morning. We're located in Tampa, Florida. Yep, you're right. If you go to bigcatrescue.org/catbio, you can read about every single one of our cats. Hi, Suzanne.
Here's Mr. Apollo. Apollo is a Siberian lynx.
Thank you guys so much for helping me answer questions. I only get to see two at a time and they kind of fly by, so I apologize if we miss any questions. Myself or Luana goes back through the feed after it's over and we can answer any questions that might have been missed.
Come here. Come here. Where are you going? Sam is going to lockout.
Good job.
Good job, buddy.
Later, somewhere.
Later you get more treats.
Come on, baby.
And this is Running Bear Bobcat. He loves to use those paws.
I don't need to be ready for that. Ready to open the mouth. Good boy.
Good job.
Here.
Let's see just how fierce these little bobcats really are.
Alright, an explosion of meat now.
Big cats are actually solitary by nature. They normally would develop their own territory in the wild and wouldn't be living in large groups. Lions are the only ones that would live in a pride like that. Running Bear is so handsome.
Hey, Mr. Apollo, Mr. Hufflepuff. All right, buddy. We gotta keep moving on.
Good boy. Good boy.
Good job, boys.
Yep, and we'll move fairly quickly through this because these are just their meds and supplements and we have to give them out in a timely manner so that then their full diets can come. Some of them need certain time limits between getting their pill and getting their diet. So we're gonna go see Pharaoh. Oh man, we've had a lot of rain. Lots of limbs and branches down. So we're gonna see Pharaoh, Andy, and Breezy. Pharaoh knows what's happening. Thank you, Tanya, for answering questions. I really appreciate it. Pharaoh knows the drill.
Hi, bud. Good morning, Deb. We're following Master Keeper, Marie, as she hands out supplements and meds this morning.
Good boy.
Good job, bud. Hi, let's get your close up. It's your 15 minutes this morning, bud. See, where's the rest? It comes next.
whole diets will be fed out once all the volunteers have done morning chores. And there's Ariel up there on her platform. Good morning, everybody. It's Brittany and Marie at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. Here's Lakota Bobcat and Sue over there. So the rest of the keepers are out this morning closing lockouts and separating cats that do live together. We have some siblings that live together, and they do have to be separated for feeding time because we would not want to take a chance on any aggression. All the cats mean serious business when it comes to food. There's Miss Lovey.
Lovey Bobcat.
Thurston is down there. Thank you, Tony, for donating. We really appreciate it. Andy Bobcat.
Andy! Andy!
Andy girl!
It's a peekaboo day. Oh, I see you.
I see you,
Yeah, she gets a little nervous. Andy was recently in the hospital. We think she possibly had a stroke. She was really off balance, didn't seem to be hearing or seeing very well. So what we did is we put her little treat in on a little paper plate. And we're gonna leave it. We're gonna leave it for her to come out at her own pace. And this is Breezy Bobcat. Andy Bobcat that I was talking about. She spent several days in the hospital, but since she's come back outside, she's actually doing pretty good. She's going back to her lockout for food. She's laying in all of her same favorite places. Thank you, Lynn, for your donation. Good morning, Karma.
Good girl.
Good girl. It's your girl. All right, here's Breezy. From a distance, you can see Andy coming out. Be very quiet.
I'm not
We're gonna vacate the area for Andy. We know she'll come get it. She just does not trust us still standing there. So if you guys are just joining us, this is Brittany and Master Keeper Marie handing out morning meds and supplements. If I miss any questions, I'll try to go back through the feed. There she goes. All right. Yeah, Tut seems to really be enjoying his new enclosure. He's eating really well. He's very talkative. He's enjoying definitely being along the tour path because he sees so many of us and is always talking. Oh, there's my little girl.
Hi, Miss Lily. Girl.
Thank you, Leslie, for your donation.
All right, breakfast is coming. We don't want to trick you.
Thank you so much for your donations. Good morning, Lauren. Or it's probably not morning there, but it's morning here. Lauren B.
Oh.
We We are doing morning meds and supplements. So you guys are just seeing a little treat to these cats. They will be getting their full breakfast next. Keepers are out separating cats, putting down feeding lockouts for everybody's safety. And then everybody will go out and feed. Thank you. And thank you to everybody who's donating, sharing, and asking questions. And those of you answering those questions, thank you, thank you.
I'm down to Keeper.
All right, we're gonna go to Servi Serval next.
I have Amanda and Tiger Rose.
Here goes Zuhari.
Tiger Rose.
On his morning run.
They're usually fed around 8:30. That gives us enough time to get in at 7 and 7:30, do meds and supplements, get everything ready for everybody, and then come back out with food. We have about 70 cats.
That's Servi right there.
And her silly neighbor, Zuhari, over here. Yeah, Zuhari is one of our younger residents.
Here, treat.
He gets a good neighbor treat.
Yeah, that's all yours.
She gets the other part that actually has the med in it.
Oops, almost.
Oh, that was almost a real good catch. So Sheena's supplement comes first, and then she has to wait an hour, and then she'll get her full diet.
And here's Ginger.
Oh, that's good. There we go. All right. Yeah, most of the small cats have a minimum of 1,200 square feet, but most of them have a lot more than that. It's bigger than my own house. We've got about a 900 square foot house in St. Pete, so. Lots of dens, lots of platforms. So you have Frosty over here, and Miss Natalia up there. Frosty's gonna get a good boy treat.
Oh, my Frosty, yay!
Oh, behind ya!
Follow your nose, there you go. Yeah, I never know if it's Beecher or Hutch now. They have taken on the same sound and they talk to each other nonstop. Natalia moved off the platform and is now stalking us from behind the Palmetto.
Hello to Michigan.
Yeah, it's either Beecher or Hutch.
Or both.
Or both. Yeah, they like to combine voices.
And the Sundari's enjoying vacation. I know where my food comes from.
Yeah, Florida's been really wet. It's a little early for our rain season.
There's Mr. Manny.
Right, I believe we're going to Diablo,
and then we go to
Riza.
There's Diablo.
Thank you, Sherry, you too. I was gonna say he's probably really well hidden.
Let me give him a little.
There's that buddy.
Hi.
Hi, Cyrus. What are you doing down there?
Unbelievable.
I can never keep him in my frame. He jumps so high.
And he got it.
And you got it. You're such a good caracal. You're such a good caracal.
Yeah. And he caught his too.
I know.
And there he goes.
Yeah, he's good at that.
And he's gone. So he caught that.
I know. Hi, sweet pea.
I know.
That was good?
That was yummy.
Nope, we have a pretty effective hurricane plan in place through Irma. Everybody stayed in place, and the majority of the staff and interns hunkered down in the gift shop and checked on the cats every hour. And we only had a couple trees that came down. Nothing was compromised, and our plan showed that it worked pretty well, so. Back here is where Maya, Ryza, and Mac live.
Come on, Ryza.
Thank you.
Hi, Maya. So Maya doesn't get this kind of med. She gets lactulose in her food, but that comes with her full diet. So we're just out doing the pre-breakfast meds and supplements.
You need to come down, sweetie.
And this is Mac. Yeah.
Hi, baby.
Good morning, Sherry. This is Mac getting his morning meds and supplements from Master Keeper Marie. Maya is very pretty. I never thought I could fall for another cougar after we lost Aspen Echo. But man, Maya. Then Maya showed up. So. No, these are wild animals. And they pretty much show their wild side a lot and randomly, and especially when food is involved. Ryza can be the sweetest little girl talking to you and all nice, and check this out.
The first pieces go okay.
Oh, that was good.
Yeah, that's only the first.
You learning manners.
Lynn, go to bigcatrescue.org/get-involved, if somebody can post that link.
Good.
Oh, you did so good.
You had to prove me wrong, didn't you?
Everyone else that has watched you before can vouch.
Yeah. You were a sneaky girl today.
She's a good girl. She's a good girl. She's young the best.
Aw, good job, lady. She did. She did everything we never get her to do. Thank you, Deb.
Good job.
Yep, I moved here from Ohio 3 years ago to get involved, and my husband and I live in St. Pete, and we're now both senior keepers out here.
Love that boy.
All right, bye, Mac Mac. Let's get your close up.
Hi.
Good morning.
Hi, sweetheart.
Alright, we gotta go see some other kitties. Alright, here's Maya.
Alright, breakfast is next, guys.
Are you chasing?
Alright, bye, lady.
Maya. Where is my tree?
Alright, and who's next?
We're gonna go to Des.
Okay, so we're gonna see Des Sturville. Thank you to everybody who is donating, sharing, asking, and answering questions. It's how we reach more people, and we help educate people that have questions. So thank you guys so much. Does anybody else not have sound? Good morning, Anna.
Is Keisha on the way, though?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it looks like she's in her den.
Oh, she's in
the den. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Chris. Yeah, it's a beautiful morning. We've been getting torrential rain almost every day for the last week or more, but today it looks like it's all going to be in the PM, so I wanted to try to get out here early. Make sure you guys got to see some kitties today. Okay, thanks, guys. Thanks, Jamie, for sharing. Yep, we are GFAS accredited, so we do not buy, sell, trade, breed, or touch any of our animals here. Hi, Amy. And we do that because these are wild animals. They wouldn't be letting you touch them in the wild. They certainly don't want it when they're trapped in a cage. And even our cats that were in private ownership that people think should have been used to being petted and would enjoy it. Afton made a really great video showing some of our Savannahs. They wanted absolutely nothing to do with our retractable scratchers, which is what mimics the feel of them being pet. And they didn't like it at all. We pretty much only use those on the older cats that have trouble grooming.
Hi, Keisha.
I'm gonna keep my distance. She's pretty testy sometimes.
Keisha. Good morning, Mary.
Keisha.
Keisha. I can hear Nikita roaring. Yeah, she was very aggressive over the weekend, and then all of a sudden now she's being the exact opposite. So I don't know if she's going back into heat or what the situation is.
I've never seen that side of her.
Mm-mm. Anna, we feed quite a variety of foods. We thaw out 500 pounds of meat a day, and that's anything from, you know, your typical red or beef, chicken of all kinds, chicken necks, chicken thighs, chicken legs. We do turkey in a whole variety, turkey legs, turkey breast. We have a product called mush, which is the entire beef basically ground up. They're pure carnivores, so it's all raw meat. We're gonna go over and see Desi Serval next. Yeah, absolutely. Ask questions. I mean, it's how we all learn. I moved here not nearly knowing what I know now. It's part of the process. Yeah. I'll actually walk through here. Thank you so much for sharing. She's just pulling up to Dev Serval. Yeah, so actually we have a serval right now named Sheena. Her owner just fed her dry cat food for a long time, and she has a really weird, picky allergy actually to beef and red. So she primarily is on fish and shrimp and chicks. Oh, I see him. He's such a good hider, but I spotted him. He's all the way on the other side, of course. Well, a lot of our cats are quite older in age as well, so they might be big, but they don't eat nearly as much as they used to. Now, Desi is a three-legged serval. He was found that way in Arizona. Abandoned. Good morning, Dee Dee.
Oh, there he is.
Des is so good at hiding. Marie had to walk all the way around his enclosure. Oh yeah, their wild instinct is to pounce. But to be totally honest, Des is faster on three legs than some are on four. Yeah, we don't know what happened. We just know that when they found him, he already had three legs and he was exhausted and basically passed out on the side of the road in the Catalina foothills. So I'm sure abandoned by an owner. He's living life now. Yep, nope, that's just how he is. But he can run and jump and climb and... Yep, some were privately owned. You can read about every single one of our cats at bigcatrescue.org/catbio. And then you can choose by species and by cat. A lot of good information on our website. Yep, they were either owned by humans or used by humans. That's how we got most of them. Some are ex-circus performers. Some were used in the cub breeding industry, which is terrible. Thank you, Ginger. Thank you, Deb, for posting those links. There's Gabby over there waiting on her breakfast. So if you guys are just joining us, this is Brittany and Marie at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. We are handing out morning meds and supplements. So what you're seeing are just little treats that just contain their medications. And then their full breakfast comes later in the morning. Yep, a lot of these cats, I think we have 20 over the age of 20.
Hi, Dee Dee.
So a lot of them are getting kind of old age medications, pain meds, arthritis meds, things like that. From a young age in hopes of making white ligers, which is just awful. Zabu was born with quite a few birth defects. She has a cleft lip and a terrible set of teeth in her mouth, unfortunately.
Cam, are you going to participate today?
Let me actually walk down to a gate.
Cameron. Cameron's so picky. Yeah. Hi. Good job, lady.
Yeah, she's been getting more and more into morning yoga. It's absolutely adorable.
Yeah, chuffy girl. Alright, let's go see if we can get Cameron to take his meds. Good job, lady.
Good girl.
You just stay right there. Breakfast is next. Oh, sweet girl. All right, let's go see Cameron. Bye, baby girl.
Oh, Kelly has quickly grown on me as a keeper. I absolutely love Seth. I love Hoover. And Khalid came out of nowhere and stole my heart. Let's see if we can get Cam to do his pills. We're gonna stay kind of far back because we want him to take his pills. Yeah, Mickey's Rescue, when I first came across that video, I cried for a week.
Cameron, you gotta participate today.
Actually, I can imagine. I just went to India with several people from Big Cat. Our sole purpose was to see tigers in the wild, and I think between the entire group over not quite 2 weeks, we saw 14 total out in the wild. Male, female, cubs, a whole variety. I can't even explain what your heart and your chest feels like when you see that. Spent a lot of time crying, thinking about our cats stuck here in cages because of things humans do. He's being picky as always. Yeah, it was one of the most incredible things I've ever done. It was actually my first international trip ever. Believe that. I went big. He is beautiful. He's actually going to get a whole turkey today, assuming that he takes his meds. We need him to get his meds in there. Actually, was full of silly energy last night. I came walking past and he was frolicking around and he was scratching on his favorite tree that I've always seen the scratch marks and knew it was possible but never actually witnessed him do it. And lucky for me, I actually had my camera on me, so I hope to share those photos soon. It was pretty adorable.
He had to go see his lady.
Zabu wants to see if there's anything left. Always.
Always, Boo. Hi. Good morning.
She's such a good girl. She knows to keep her distance while he's getting his food.
Yeah. You know to keep your distance.
That's correct. Yeah, he's a lion. She's a white tiger. He was fully neutered, and that is testosterone driven. So because of that, he did lose his mane. We'll see if he gives us a roar this morning. That's what he did yesterday. He might just flop down. Looks like it's gonna be a flop. Two bites and now he needs to groom. Silly guy.
Thank you.
I hope you have an amazing day too.
Hi, lady.
So you can see she just walked into her lockout. Get some water. So you can see it's just a tiny extension off of their much larger cages. Correct. White tigers would not normally occur in the wild if they were born. It's caused by leucism, which is a genetic trait caused by inbreeding. So it's very unlikely to happen in the wild, but if it did, normally the mother wouldn't allow the cub to live because they can't hide. They don't have great camouflage, and they would put the rest of the cubs at risk. So it's more of a man-made species. All right. If you go to bigcatrescue.org/ticket, you can look at all the varieties of guided tours that we do. Nope, nothing's stuck in her mouth. She just drank water. She has a cleft lip and has really bad teeth because of her genetic disorder, her breeding issue. White tigers are all born with genetic issues. Some of them don't allow them to live very long.
Hi, Amanda. Here's Amanda. You had a catitude yesterday, ma'am.
Oh, oh, look at me.
And here's our boys. Oh.
Hi, Arthur. Hi, my love.
Hi, Andre.
Here's Andre.
So it looks like they're all already separated and locked out for feeding. Yes. So we shouldn't have any drama from Amanda, but you never know.
Here's Andre. Hi, big guy. Yeah, you guys are really shedding your winter coats. Hi, Arthur.
So in the wild, tigers would be living about 10 to 12 years. In captivity, they've been known to live into their 20s. That's because they get great vet care, good foods. If they get an injury, they...
So that's not a no for them.
That's not what he wants.
Come on, Arthur.
These guys, I believe, are 22 now.
Arthur.
Just like being well over 100 years
Arthur.
Old.
Don't want that either.
Arthur.
What about you, bud? Hi, Andre.
No, we are a no-touch facility here, Heather. These are wild animals, and if we would selfishly want to touch them out of our own greed, and they were to injure us, they could be sentenced to death for that, and that's never gonna be worth it.
Kitten Karma arriving. Andre.
Yeah, we're accredited by the Global Federation of Animal Sanctuaries. Those are the best kind of sanctuaries to follow and donate and support, because they are a no breeding, buying, selling, trading, or touching facility.
Are you so ready?
Yeah, these guys have gotten quite old quite quick. I feel like all three of them were a little more Amanda-esque when I first started. Unfortunately, the boys have been showing their age a bit. I'm 22 years old. If you times that by six, they're well into their hundreds.
Hi, big guy. This is Arthur. Hi. What you doing, big guy? You gonna take it in something? That's Cameron roaring.
Yep, we do the best that we can. They've got keepers that are observing them every single day, multiple times a day. And anything that we note in their observation charts goes to our vet group. So we're able to monitor medications, adjust medications that might be needed.
How'd you do, bud?
Oh, you have to.
Yeah.
I'm chirped.
Thank you so much for your donation. Go to Hoover. Good morning, Betsy. Hoover was all kinds of feisty yesterday after it downpoured. My office is a little bit that way down the road, and I came out to stretch my legs and check on a couple of them. And Hoover just really wanted to chase me yesterday. It was actually really kind of funny. It's nice to see him developing a personality finally, and see, he is upside down in his den. Yep, Hoover was a former circus cat in Peru. He looks like he might be in deep sleep. Oh, absolutely, Jamie. The sharing helps us a lot. We reach a lot more people that we might not have reached to begin with. Just spreading our message helps us a lot. Yeah, thank you, Laurel. Bobby, we feed once a day. Yeah, upside down. He's gonna make her work for it. We feed once a day in the morning. The cats, depending on age and weight and medical reasons, is what dictates how much they actually get fed. But most of our tigers are anywhere from 8 to 12 pounds of food a day. In the wild, they wouldn't normally eat every day. He's like, nope.
Oh, and he's got his claw on his face.
He's straight up ignoring. So Hoover looks like it's going to be a tough case for her this morning. I know everybody's asking about Zeus, so I'm going to walk down and show you Zeus. He's still hanging in there, not eating as consistently as we would like him to, but he still gets up and moves around, drinks water.
He's in a deep sleep also. You guys just aren't morning tigers, huh? Hi, Hoovy. Or not Hoovy, you're Zeusy. You're Zeus.
I won't hang around for him or Hoover this morning because I'm gonna see if we can walk back and maybe see some of the cats actually eating their diets. These guys just take a really long time to get them awake and get them out and moving. And
Mr. Zeus. So he's still doing good. He's just
a very old tiger that had a lot of ailments. Went through a lot of abuse before he got here. Yeah, both these boys are just sleeping. They actually eat more in the evenings. So for some reason, these two guys are kind of on the opposite schedule of everyone else. So any cats that don't eat in the morning or are picky, keepers go back out multiple times through the day to make sure that they do eat the weight amount that we need them to eat. Yeah, Hoover's super spoiled. I saw the ADI footage of him in that circus and all the undercover footage that they had gotten while they were tracking him down. And bless his heart, he can be as spoiled and picky as he wants to be. We're gonna do everything we can. And same thing with Zeus.
Just snoozing. So she'll have to try to come wake him up.
Yeah, exactly. Plus again, I mean, these guys would only be living 10 to 12 years.
Hi, Zeusie. Good morning, sir. There, we got you awake for Marie.
It is sad. It is.
Hi, sweet boy. You gonna be a good boy for Marie, right?
Yeah, a lot of us come out just to say hi to him and talk to him. See if she has any
luck with Hoover. She's still down there with him, so she must have gotten his attention. I would imagine when they've been that abused that they're able to go to a place that blocks us out, and I certainly can't blame them on that. This would be an interesting view. So he's eating upside down. Thank you, Paula, for donating. He does deserve these.
His eyes have closed, too.
Breakfast in bed, upside down, not even opening his eyes. Alright, we'll walk back around and see him. Yeah, none of them asked for this life, so we do as best as we can to make them as happy as possible. Yeah, Hoover's the master at training us. Good morning, Anita. Yeah, Lee, I believe he's started doing this more and more recently, but it's the first time I've seen it in person. Yeah, Michelle, we are in Tampa, Florida.
Passing on company.
Just make it a little bit tougher on her. Much to everyone who's donated, sending your love to Hoover. Thank you also for sharing and helping answer questions for me. Yep, he has us trained for sure. Good morning, snack. You can roll back over now, buddy. All right, so Marie will be trying some of the cats again, and she's gonna go work with Zeus, but I wanted you guys to just see him. He's just a deep sleep in there. So Marie, we're gonna say goodbye to you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for all your support. Thank you so much.
Yes. We'll see you next time. Yes. So let me see, because I have to walk back to food prep anyway. So what we're gonna do is walk and see who we might see along the way. So we're going back by the Texas boys. All right, you boys eat breakfast. Panda. Hi, Miss Amanda. Hi, Arthur. Such a good boy. Hi. Good morning, lady. I know that look. I'm gonna keep walking. Alright. So what Marie is actually gonna do next after she gets Zeus and Cameron their meds, she brought the Outback food diets as well, and that takes just as long and just as picky usually, so. So we'll head through and see if we can find anybody. Good, Sherry, I'm glad.
All right, Sabu, breakfast is next.
So this would be a good time if anybody has any questions that didn't get answered, because I'm walking and I might be able to actually see them. Oh, bye, Sherry. Yep, have a wonderful day. If you guys are just joining, you'll be able to watch this whole feed once it's over. We did morning meds with Master Keeper Marie. Hi, everybody. Hope you all have a wonderful day at work. Mr. Cameron should be getting a turkey today. Nope, it's pretty rough. The only time that we've ever touched the cats is when they go into the hospital for a procedure. We're in Tampa, Florida. Yeah, Diana, I'll definitely be here for the walkabout. And Amanda, that's awesome. That's very true. So you can see this fencing that is between Kali and Cameron and Zabu. That's because Kali likes to harass Cameron and get him all riled up. So he focuses a little bit better when they can't see each other. We're just walking back to food prep. And if we see anybody eating along the way, we'll stop and say hi. Like they haven't gotten to Kali yet. I'm not sure if there will be another live feed today, but it would be this afternoon.
Miss Kali, are you gonna get breakfast?
Yeah. I'm not sure, Tanya. You're right, Cameron does only have eyes for Sabu.
Are you being sweet again?
Oh.
Sharon. Miss Kali being adorable before breakfast.
Looks like we have keepers Aaron and Victoria are out feeding this route.
Hi. I know. You're such a good girl.
All right, we don't want to be a distraction. That might mean Gabrielle got her breakfast. So we'll go check on Gabby. So we're gonna walk down towards Yashi. Oh, there's one of our good friends. The reason we have the thinner layer of chicken wire around all of our cat lockouts for feeding time is because of these vultures. Great, thanks, Cindy. Have a great day.
Miss Gabby. Oh, we haven't fed her yet.
Gabby into her new enclosure overlooking the lake with some swimming pools, and she just loves it.
You love your new home.
Hi. You're kind of backlit. Hey, sweet girl.
What are you doing?
What are you doing, baby? Hi.
Yeah.
She absolutely loves this tall platform.
You're such a good girl.
Thank you, Amanda, for donating.
This is Gabrielle having her morning bath. Hi. Did you already get breakfast?
Yeah.
Hi. Little Gabby Tiger.
Taking a morning bath. Maybe we did miss her getting breakfast.
Did you
you already get breakfast? You usually don't bathe until after you eat. Yeah.
All right. Well, we might have already missed it. Everybody might just be flying through it this morning. Yeah, Gabby the pocket tiger. Her and Priya both are just teeny tiny, especially when you compare them to Kali. Definitely our largest female. All right. Maybe we'll see some of our littles. Yeah, Jamie, it's been a running joke for some of the keepers here. We call her a pocket tiger. She's so tiny, you could put her in your pocket and take her home. But obviously that's ludicrous, but it's an adorable image. And one of our artists, Jessica Marks, just painted a really cute little painting of Gabby Tiger in what looks like a little shirt pocket. Super cute. Thanks, Mary. So now we're kind of over in our smaller cat section. If I don't find anyone soon, I'll shut this down and maybe we'll be able to go live later when Cameron gets his turkey. But again, our main focus is to make sure these cats actually eat and take their meds, so we're never gonna wanna be a distraction. Yeah, Amanda and I have a very interesting relationship. A clean plate for Miss Tiger Lily, so we might have missed all the action, guys. Let's see. So you saw how active everyone is first thing in the morning. Oh, well, there's Dryden.
Hi. I didn't bring any more.
Oh.
You're so silly. You're so silly.
So the keepers have probably fed everybody and then they walk back around afterward.
There's Miss Lily. Hi. Hi.
Yeah, Lee, I kind of wonder if it's me and Carol or if it's the stabilizer is just like really throws her off. Yeah, that's typical Dryden, which is why I didn't even flinch.
Look, Lily, you're getting so many hearts.
You can go to catrescue.biz or bigcatrescue.biz and search for bracelets. We have a large variety of them, actually.
Hi. What is this thing I'm holding? Miss Lily.
This is a bobcat. I'm not totally sure, but I think she's potentially our oldest cat on property. It's either her or Ryza, our cougar. And Dryden, the one that lunged at us, is also a bobcat. They vary in size and color, depending on what region they would be found. So our Florida bobcats are a lot smaller, usually darker, and have more pattern designs on them.
What are you doing, Lily? Wait, if I crouch down, will you come over?
This would be a really good screenshot for Find the Bobcat. Yeah, Dryden and Kelowna are younger.
What are you doing, Lily? You gonna hide?
Alright, sweetheart. We'll let her back to her morning bath.
Here's Dryden again. You following me? Hi.
Oh, you're okay, wild man.
Look at those wild eyes. Look at those wild eyes. That twitchy tail. You're a good boy.
Yeah, him and Kelowna, I mean, they've been here for for a while now, and both of them are still very fierce, very shy and elusive, and I kind of love it. I love that they've really kept their wild spirit. So, let's see. Maybe Smalls is out. She's always entertaining in the morning. Yep, Lee Farrow is the only cat to successfully have marked me, marking me as his by peeing on me, and he's actually managed it on two occasions. Marianne has tried, but I've been able to dodge her. And Smalls tries all the time. There she is. Hi, Pumpkin!
You always show me your butt, huh? Sweetheart. This is Small's bobcat. No, I don't want your butt.
And now Cyrus is attempting to mark me, but he's also not been successful yet.
No, I don't want that. Are you gonna get your zoomies? You gonna get your morning zoomies?
She gets very excited in the morning. Does lots of running and jumping and bouncing.
What are you doing? Hi. Hi, cutie. Hi. Being a sweet girl. Twitchy tail. That twitchy tail. There she goes.
So you can see that tree stump in the middle of her enclosure. That used to be a fully intact tree stump. And her claws have done that. It's pretty unbelievable.
We'll see. She tends to get pretty excited in the morning. Are you gonna run around? You're so silly. Look at those beautiful eyes. Those beautiful eyes. Good morning.
There she comes.
You wild girl.
She's hard to focus on. She's so squirrely. Isn't she gorgeous?
Hi! What are you doing? You purring? I can hear you purring. You getting your neighbors riled up?
So this is from the other side. You can see that tree stump I was talking about. She has clawed and completely terrorized that thing. And she will actually pose up on top of it. She's got really good yoga skills.
Don't ya?
Well, she's very young. She's only a couple years old, so she's very feisty. Very smart, though. She's one of my operant training cats, and it took her maybe two sessions to learn some of the commands.
Smart girl. Yep, this is Smalls. Let's go see. Who else can we go see? Pumpkin.
So she already got breakfast, now she just has her morning zoomies.
There's Nabisco. And Mrs. Hi, Biscuit. Morning. Oh, No, you get out of there, cutie pie. You get out of there, cutie pie. Where's my clothes?
So if you guys are just joining us, this is Brittany at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. This is Mrs. Claus and Nabisco. Always have lots of energy first thing in the morning. And then we were just chatting with Smalls over here. Yeah, this whole section is a lot of twitchy bobcat tails. In a sanctuary where 20 of our cats are over the age of 20, it's pretty miraculous that we actually have a section where some of the cats are younger. So it's like we have a geriatric unit and a nursery unit. These guys are all just a few years old, which are babies for us. There should be a donate button on your screen, or you can go to bigcatrescue.org/donate.
Got some enrichment.
And this is Smalls Bobcat. We actually foster domestic kittens here. So we have a place that we call the Kitten Cabana, and domestic cats from Tampa Bay Humane Society come and live on property with our interns until they are of proper size and weight and health to be adopted. Those are the only kittens we have. You see her climbing her tree over there. The only kittens we have on property, and those are the only cats on property we touch. We are GFAS accredited. So we do not buy, sell, trade, breed, or touch any of our cats here. And this is Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. And this is Smalls Bobcat with her morning, her wild morning energy. When this live feed is over, you guys will be able to go back and you'll see that we followed Marie, one of our master keepers, as she handed out morning meds and supplements. We checked in on Zeus. We watched Hoover have breakfast in bed.
You are so crazy.
She's just so active, she's hard to keep up with, so hopefully I'm not making anyone feel sick. Thank you if that's Luana. I'm not sure if it's Luana or Carol answering questions. Appreciate it. This cat that you're looking at here, her name is Smalls, and she's a bobcat. Yeah. Yes, thank you, Deb. We have 5 cameras, including one in the kitten cabana. And you can watch the cats 24/7. I love watching Seth and Andy and Tiger Lake. Yeah, she's being a wild one this morning.
All right, small girl, we're gonna move on.
Good morning, Carol. All right, let's check in on the biscuits one more time, and then we'll go say hi to Tut.
What are you doing, wild man? Where's Nabisco? Hello, hi, good morning.
These guys are very frisky in the morning. You can see how big and tall he's gotten. Nabisco's kind of in his awkward teenage years right now, where he used to be like a little butterball. And now he's tall and lanky. There he goes. All right, let's see what King Tut is up to. You guys can see how he's settled into his new home. Everybody already got their breakfast in this section. I didn't make it back from Outback in time. Let's see. He's got a couple spots now. Oh, there he is. Hi, bud.
Good morning. This is King Tut. He's one of our Savannah cats. He got a new home enclosure that's right on the tour path. John, we'd love for you to visit the sanctuary. He's still very adorable. Thank you, Deb. All the action over here, which I think he really enjoys. What are you doing?
He just constantly watches everything. He's real talkative again. always wants you to pay attention. Yeah, I've been a keeper out here for 3 years, so they're really used to me coming around. Also take a lot of photos, so they're kind of used to me having some kind of foreign object with me, like a camera.
What are you doing, Tut?
He's like, you interrupted my bath. He's also got a direct view of the new gift shop. Sorry if I'm blinding you. And he seems to really enjoy being able to watch everything happening. Look at those gorgeous eyes.
All right, bud. Enjoy your morning bath.
Okay, well, this is about the time where everyone starts taking their baths, going into their dens to sleep for the rest of the day. I wanted to get out here early for you guys today. We've had a lot of rain this week, and today's going to be no different by the afternoon from what I've heard. Here's Miss Perfection. Kind of a rarity.
Hi.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Miss Grumbly.
Perfection is our only ocelot, and she pretty much hides all day. She's like, no, thank you. And that was Perfection's 15 minutes. We don't like to make them nervous, so we'll keep walking. At least you guys got a good view of her. Yeah, she's gorgeous. All right, our last hope for a cat's gonna be Breezy. And I see her. Hi, Breezy. You actually saw her earlier if you've been following us from the beginning. She gets morning meds and supplements. Pretty girl.
Anytime we're in the gift shop, you should have taken Tegan with you.
Hi. So everybody got their breakfast already. And now it's time to get sleepy with their full bellies. So if you guys watch this when it's over, you'll see Master Keeper Marie handing out supplements and meds to servals, bobcats, lynx, tigers. Yeah. Baby Kicks the Genet is actually out in the staff offices. I'm nowhere near there right now. But he has a webcam, if anybody on here can post that link. I love how they'll lay down where I can see them, but they never look at me. You hear that sound? That's Gabrielle Tiger calling. Well, I will probably leave you guys here. This is a pretty long feed for this morning, but I want to thank you all so much for joining us, your support for the cats. Thank you for asking questions. Thank you for answering questions. To everyone who donated and shared, that really means a lot to us. So thank you guys. I hope you all have a great day. Thank you, Deb. Yep, we really appreciate your support, and we will see you next time. Thank you.